Hello and welcome to the second half of my concept presentation. This part is about adaptive product design. When products fail, it's not like everything is equally worn out, but instead a lot of parts can still work much longer. When you see a disassembled old washing machine, you will for example be amazed to see how the stainless steel drum inside it still looks brand new, which has inspired designers before to repurpose them as lampshades, furniture, or to even rethink the washing machine as such, as can be seen in this video. So instead of replacing the whole device, it is of course more sustainable to just repair or if necessary replace the part that is broken. But you usually need an identical replacement because the system is not designed to adapt to different parts. However, if there were adaptive products that could be equipped with unspecific components, the value of those components as a resource would increase and it would create an incentive to remove them before disposing of a device. So I started to think about how such an adaptive product would have to be designed. If we take a hand blender for example, sometimes the electronics or the motor fail, but in a lot of generic models it is also often the connection between motor and blade that breaks, which can be complicated to repair or to get a replacement for, and results in a lot of blenders being thrown away with the electronics and motor working perfectly fine. To address this situation, we could for example start to produce unfinished blenders that do not require manufacturer-specific parts to complete and can be equipped with working electric components from unusable blenders. Then you could download the model of an enclosure from an online library and 3D print it. Like the coupling needs to be able to adapt to different motor shafts, aspects of the enclosure should ideally also be adaptive, so not everything has to be reprinted when something needs to be replaced. Over time, the open source enclosure design can be optimized by the online community. Another example of a product that is often disposed of with working components inside is the vacuum cleaner, with its potentially reusable hose, pipe and nozzle, motor and power cord. Well, you could take those things and use some polyester fabric to make yourself a washable dust bag with a 3D printed connector and use generic filter fabric to make two air filters in 3D printed fixtures. Moreover, you would also print a mount that fits your motor and can ideally be adapted to fit others as well. Now get some planks and fireproof noise cancelling material to build a box with a hole in its side for a 3D printed adapter that fits your hose. Install your components in the box, steal some casters from an old office chair, and you have built an adaptive vacuum cleaner. If you are curious where this project is going and how I turn those concepts into reality or come up with something entirely different, you can subscribe to my channel to be informed when I upload new videos. On timkramer.com you can also find further resources and status updates of my progress. You have any suggestions or thoughts to share? Feel free to post a comment below the video. Thank you for watching!